Did you know that there are three common math errors? In this video, we're going to talk about what they are and how you can help kind of fight against them. We're going to talk about that in this video, so stay tuned. Hi everybody, this is Karen. Welcome back to our channel called Our House. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing. If you'd like to go from questions to confidence when it comes to the Robinson curriculum, I'm here to answer questions. And I see a lot of frustration in this question asked a lot. How can I encourage my child with Saxon math, doing it independently on their own without helping them? How can I help them without helping them? So let's talk about the three major errors and how you can help them without really helping them, right? So number one is carelessness. This is just writing numbers down wrong, maybe not lining them up correctly. And so one way that you can help your student when it comes to that is something like this. This is our Saxon math answer book, and inside it has the spaces for the 30 math problems. But as you can see, in the boxes, it's graph paper. Graph paper is a great way to help reduce careless errors. They can line the numbers up correctly. It's just a neater way to do their math problems. So something like this can really help them with careless math errors. Number two is computational. This is where they just maybe added wrong, or they didn't do, you know, the problem inside the parentheses first, just computational, the actual workings of the problem. They understand the concept and how to work the problem, but they just computationally did something wrong. So how can you help your student to kind of fight back against this? So actually, a product that I have designed for that after reading the RC course of study is the Saxon Math Error Tracking. This, believe it or not, really does help with those computational errors. It really encourages a student to get the problem right the first time, to be more careful, because what happens is after they grade themselves, you know, that first time they work all the problems and they grade themselves, they write down the lesson number and then how many that they got wrong. Well, obviously no student likes seeing, you know, having 8 or 9 wrong. They want to be down here where the line is for 1 to 2, that 3% error mark. So just that simple thing of constantly seeing this at their desk and seeing maybe errors up here, they will naturally want to work harder to bring their errors down here. And we use this also if they're getting a lot of errors, then we know to scale it back to half a lesson until they can come back to maybe just 1 or 2 wrong. Then they can go back to trying another full lesson. This is a very helpful tool when it comes to fighting against computational errors. And the third common error is just conceptual. They don't understand the concept. It's not so much about carelessness or just working the problem wrong. They really don't understand how to work the problem. So how can you help your student with this? Well, in the Saxon math books, a lot of times there's little parentheses after each problem that explains to you where that lesson, where that concept was first introduced. So teach them to go back to that and to reread that lesson. And it's also very helpful to do things like the rubber ducky technique, where they have a rubber ducky and they're teaching that concept to the rubber ducky, or teaching anything really, any doll, stuffed animal, whatever. It's just them teaching somebody else that information. This is also talked about in the overnight student. If you want to check that out, it's in the RC contents. You can read about it and see what a powerful technique it is and use it in this way to help with the conceptual part of learning math. All right, so that's it for this video on the three common math errors and how you can fight against it. I will link the information for these products in the description below if you want to check it out. And if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in another video. Bye.